Welcome back to Ortho Implants for Life, your one-stop channel to learn about orthopedic implant industry. Today, we'll walk through the operating procedure for the periprosthetic plate. So let's jump into the video. First, the doctor will choose the plate size and whether to take a 11, 13, 15 or 17 hole plate, and will also choose the side depending on the fractured leg, whether it is left or right. After that, we will have to fix the blade in the bone using a K-wire here at the distal end of the plate. For any periprosthesis case, it is important to first lock the cable before the plate fixation. Now to do cable lock, we first need a cable guide. We will insert the cable guide and then go around the bone and plate like this, and the plate will stay on top of the bone. Once the cable guide is in place, we can insert the wire through this hole and it comes out from the other end. That's what keeps the plate in place. Once the cable is through, we need to pass the cable through this hole in the proximal side of the plate. We will keep the cable as it is as we will apply compression later. It's better to apply compression for the entire plate together. Once done, we will repeat the same process through the second hole. Once the cable guide is in place, we can insert the wire through this hole and it comes out from the other end. Then we remove the cable guide, pass it through the second hole, and lock the cable with the plate. That ends the cable fixation of the proximal part of the plate. The doctor now decides whether to do cable fixation in the distal part of the plate. If needed, to do that we repeat the same process. Pass the cable guide from the bottom of the plate and insert the wire through this hole and it comes out from the other end. Though there is no hole here in the distal end as it was there in the proximal end, we can use a wire mount later to fix the cable. Once we have checked that the bone and the plate is in place, we will start locking the cables one by one. In order to lock the cable, we will take the front cable pressure lock. Then we take the cable tightener tool and attach it to the front pressure lock. Then we attach the back pressure lock. Keeping the front pressure lock loose, we lock the back pressure lock and add compression to it. After applying compression, we lock the front pressure lock and remove the back pressure lock along with the cable tightener tool. We keep the front pressure lock attached with first cable or cut it using a wire cutter and lock it. Thereafter, we take another front pressure lock and repeat the same process for the second cable of the proximal end of the plate. The wire passes through here. Attach the back pressure lock. Keeping the front pressure lock loose, we lock the back pressure lock. And add compression to the second cable. Again, after applying compression, we lock the front pressure lock and remove the back pressure lock along with the cable tightener tool. After this, we hold the cable using the flat connector gripper for both cables. After this, we hold the cable using the flat connector gripper for both cables. and then use a cable or wire cutter to cut the cable down. This concludes the wire fixation. Next, the plate fixation. The doctor decides that whether or not cortical screw is needed to be fixed. It is needed if the plate stays a little elevated from the bone surface. If required, we will first take a drill bit for 4.5 mm non-locking cortical screw and drill through the hole where the screw is needed to be fixed. After drilling, we will use a depth gauge to measure the length of the screw required to be fixed. Then we take a 4.5 mm screwdriver and fix the 4.5 mm cortical screw with it in the plate. Next, we fix the locking screw. Again, this has to be determined by the doctor whether or not locking screw is required. First, we attach the locking drill sleeve in the hole where we want to fix the 5 mm locking screw. Then, we will take a 3.9 mm drill bit for 5 mm locking screw and drill through the drill sleeve. After drilling, we remove the locking sleeve and use a depth gauge to measure the length of the screw required to be fixed. Then we take a 3.5 mm star-headed screwdriver and fix the 5 mm locking screw with the plate. The locking screw goes in the hole. The best part is that it locks with every thread of the locking screw hole. If the doctor determines that the locking screw is locked here only, it is left there only. Or the doctor can keep locking it all the way through. That concludes the periprosthetic plate fixation. This is how it looks after all the screw fixation.
If you have enjoyed the video, like it, share it. If you are new to our channel, subscribe it. Hit the bell icon to get the notifications for our upcoming videos. If you have any queries, comment below and we will surely reply back. If you want to know more about career prospects in orthopedic implant industry and wish to start a career in orthopedic implant industry, please click the link below in the description box and DM us to know more. Thank you and see you in our next video.